Bye-bye. Ooh, it's a big dead rat. I get paid enough for this.
You can see here, a rat or a mouse has been chewing through the cable.
You can know, mate.
On my knee.
Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Here today, me and Ross are out in Guelph at this single story house. Just looking to do a partial rewire. So the client's been told by a couple other electricians that some cabling in the house is looking a bit dodgy and old. So we're gonna take a look throughout the whole roof space, check it over, make sure everything's nice and compliant. As well as Ross is getting started on now is the switchboard upgrade. So we're getting rid of the old circuit breakers and RCD combos and putting in brand new RCBOs all throughout the board. So we're gonna get stuck straight into it. Hopefully nice, quick, easy job. Hopefully make the client's life a little safer electrical wise and get everything in the house working up and running again. I was talking to the client just before and she was saying that yeah, this part of the house is what she's been told is a bit not up to standard. So I'm just opening up these tiles. I can already see a bit of black cable and a cut earth. So I think I'm on the right track. Just gonna hop in. Hopefully it doesn't rain while these tiles are open. Bye bye. Hey mate.
Hey.
Yeah, so I've got a junction here. It's a black cabling, but it's got that bare earth.
Yeah.
It's just all been snipped back. So the earth's earth's not connected at all. I just got Ross to come up and take a look at this first junction I found for these lights in this room. They were previously been removed, but everything's still connected. And you can see that they've chopped the earths on all the TPS. So this house is, well, this section of the house at least, hopefully not much more of the house, but is not protected by any earthing system, that like the one we use in Australia. So highly dangerous if there's a fault that ever occurs, because you can end up being the person that becomes part of the circuit and that's where that fault goes. But so we're gonna remove those, gonna rehook up those earths. Gonna run a new TPS for the light because previously they used a twin cable just for an active and neutral without the earth. So gonna rerun that as well and reinstate that into the situation. Hopefully once we turn it on and Ross is finished with the switchboard upgrade, there's no problems tripping and there's not an actual fault on the line. But fingers crossed, we'll connect these earths in and hopefully all good from there. I gotta take a look around the rest of the roof now. It smells like rat in there.
All right guys, hey, so here we're gonna upgrade a switchboard like James said. So basically we're upgrading these old push-in circuit breakers. They're not as reliable as these RCBOs. They're a circuit breaker RCD combination. And then that is more sensitive, so that'll trip off much quicker, makes it much more safer in the house. And then we're gonna put a brand new enclosure in here. And then that'll tidy up all of this, make it look nice and be safer for the customer. So we were just upgrading to get rid of these things. They're just bunnies pushing things that make it, yeah, people think it's actually doing the right thing, but it's not. It needs to be safe. Yeah, it takes a little bit longer to label, but at the end of the day, it's a lot quicker once it comes to fit off, because then you know just exactly which socket you're going to put in. So I'm going to take all this old infrastructure off so I can mount the new enclosure to the back plate and drill some holes so I can feed the cables through and reconnect. Obviously technology and stuff obviously gets better over time, and these were good for the time, the RCDs, so it protected multiple circuits at once. But new regulations that come through now that every circuit has to have one of those safety, those RCBOs. The new enclosure will cover all those holes, because basically you can't have anything in the switchboard that is big enough for your finger to fit through. Otherwise you have to fire seal the whole thing, which we will do at the end. Just makes it safe and compliant, because if there ever is a fire in the switchboard, the fire seal doesn't prevent the fire, it just reduces the spread quickly.
Just grabbing some gear, gonna hop in the roof and start rewiring that first part while Ross is still doing the board. And then he can give me a hand, because the roof space is pretty tight. Barely get in there, so just need to trace some cables out. So always easier with two people. Heaps of exposed junctions. They've used twin actives, just actives and neutrals, so no earth onto any of the lights. So lots to fix up, I think. Yeah, hopefully Ross gets finished with that board quick, and then we can get stuck straight into it.
All right, so basically we're just doing some making sure this will fit on nicely. So I still got room to connect it to the actual enclosure. And then I'm gonna drill a couple of holes here for the cables to come through, and then we mount our breakers and everything on this here. So we'll start, ideally have the main switch up here, and then higher circuits to the lower circuit. So it'll be main switch, solar, any heavy draws, ovens, hot plates, then powers, ACs, and then lights at the end. The normal person doesn't really have to touch a switchboard, only if your RCD's trip. Then you can come out and you can reset your RCD. And the beauty of these new RCBOs is like, it's just the individual circuit will turn off. You won't lose a bulk of the house. Yeah, that's it really. And then if it still trips, that's when you call an electrician. Or us. Mm-hmm. Brillare. All right. My knee.
You can know, mate.
My knee.
Just closing up these tiles quickly. Gonna have to get back here, but I can feel it starting to sprinkle. Don't want to get any rain into the roof. But otherwise, I'm just about to hop back in and start rewiring that first section that we were in. And at least I can manage to fit in that bit. And then hopefully by that time, Ross has finished doing the switchboard and he can give me a hand with the rest of the house. Heaps of exposed light junctions. So just exposed connections in the roof. So if anything happens, it's really risky because it can possibly cause a fire or of such in the roof. And then obviously that's not something anybody wants in their house. So we use the junction boxes as a double insulated enclosure just for connections, just to keep them secure, out of the way of the elements, out of the way of animals and rats and stuff from getting near those connections, and just ensuring that your house is safe.
So you bring the cables through here. It's a bit overkill the hole size, but I like to work easily and I can just fill it with fire seal once I'm done. So that's your RCBOs, that's your circuit breaker RCD combinations. So basically we're gonna put each individual circuit into them. And then we run from the other side that goes to the main switch, and then the end for your neutral goes into your neutral bar. So I'll just run it up here, and then that's your so that's your main neutral from the street. So that'll go into the top one, and every installation should have an MEN, which is the protective earth and neutral system. And that's joined behind here, but I'll double check that before we're finished to make sure it has an MEN, otherwise we'll put one in here. the RCBOs, and then once we've done that, we're going to start doing the switchboard wiring to the top of the main switch. Everything's wired inside the board now, so basically you just got to make sure all the neutrals correspond with which circuit it is. It's part of the regulations, so neutral 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and so on. And I'm just going to label it up so I can put the cover on and put stickers on so it's nice and neat. So I'll fire seal it at the very end, these holes here, and there's a couple down here. But yeah, I'll do it last because if we have to run a new circuit, if there's a problem with during the rewire, we can run it with ease, and you don't have to cut away the fire seal or get it all over your hands because it does get pretty messy. So basically these are the labels we put on. It just makes it look a lot neater than writing with a text or pen. Just to let people know which circuit's which, because a normal person will just look at that and think, okay, I've no idea what's going on. But if the stickers are there, then they'll know which circuit's which. Alright guys, so switchboard upgrade's all done. So now you've got all your nice and neat looking RCBOs. The other board, like we mentioned before, was not safe. It would do the job, but it wouldn't do the job right. It's not very as sensitive as these. If there's ever an issue, it'll just trip off one circuit and then, they'll be able to know. So it was pretty straightforward, pretty easy, no real dramas. So now we're just going to get back to the rewire with James and we'll go from there. See you, mate.
Did you get any of James?
I'm skinny, mate. All right, guys, still alive up here. Just, making some junctions safe and whatnot, working my way through the roof. Ross is taking his sweet time with the switchboard, but once he's finished, he'll be up here as well. So he's talking rubbish. He can't get in the roof, can't fit in. But yeah, once he's done that, he's gonna come give me a hand. Hopefully we'll be able to smash it out a little quicker. It'd be much nicer if I had my pliers on me, but somebody lost them the other day, Ross. So I've just been running some new, replacing some old cable. It's pretty pretty crap and doesn't isn't up to standard nowadays. So I replaced those cables and then put junction boxes on them, made them all safe. So nothing bad's gonna happen, you know? But apart from this side of the house mostly is the worst part. Once we go into the rest of the building, it looks like it gets a bit better, as if this was maybe an old garage or something. So fingers crossed, it's not too bad from here on out. Almost finishing this section, so fingers crossed. Like an uncoordinated elephant. An elephant.
We're rewiring because of old cabling and also the issues of this. If you can see here, a rat or a mouse has been chewing through the cable. It's got like little teeth marks through it. So that's what we've got to watch for, and that's what we'll replace as well. So this one we're going to cut away and let's redo the junction, follow the cable down, and then make sure it's all good on the other end. So someone's attached a extension cord into the junction. Someone obviously thought themselves as an electrician. Don't do that. So some people they'll just tap in. This has obviously been done by someone that used to live here. They've used the white as a neutral, which is a big no-no. They must have had a plugged in light somewhere back in the day. But that's all good, get rid of it.
You all right?
Yeah. Just gave me a fright.
So we just turned the power and lights on about the halfway point. We've pretty much covered that first section of the roof, and now just one of the light circuits are tripping when we use the roller blinds control. So we're just trying to work out what's going on there before we move any further, just in case any other faults arise, then we don't know where the fault is or which fault that we fix and which fault is still occurring. It gets confusing. That's why we like to stop at about a halfway point just to look at what's happening, make sure everything's happening correctly. And if not, we can then fix it straight away before we move on too far and then we're completely lost in what's going on.
Are they moving?
Yeah, that's two working.
Are the blinds actually moving?
Yeah. Oh, this one won't stop now.
I'm number one.
Yeah, this one won't stop, Ross.
Yeah, it's got a limit on it, mate. You got to flick it the other way. It's up and down. It's hard being the best sometimes. All right, guys. So we're basically finishing up now. Everything's done in the roof. Switchboard's up and running, on. And yeah.
House is completely safe, fully earthed, completely and perfectly functioning and working. And hopefully this client will have no further problems in the future, coming with tripping, any electrical faults, or hopefully anything.
Yeah.
Thanks to the Brillare team.
Yeah.
The A team, James and Ross. So I'll catch you guys next time. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Catch you guys.
Sponsors.
Milwaukee.